Zika virus is a flavivirus. It's an infection that's carried by mosquitoes, and it causes an illness that's usually very mild. It can even be asymptomatic. One of the reasons that the Zika virus is of so much concern lately is not from the infection itself, but of the late consequences, particularly in pregnant women. So this is what has caused the largest degree of concern. Congenital abnormalities that have been linked to infection of pregnant women with the Zika virus, and that has later effects on the fetus. In terms of a vaccine, we don't have a vaccine for this disease either, but there are several candidate vaccines that are in research stages right now, and we're hopeful that perhaps within a year or so we'll have some clinical trials ongoing with vaccines to prevent this disease. So at Johns Hopkins Medicine, we are well positioned to address many aspects of an infectious disease threat like the Zika virus. For instance, at the Bloomberg School of Public Health, we have many researchers who are doing vaccine development research on similar diseases like dengue, and these efforts could be repurposed to develop vaccines for Zika virus infection to prevent the infection. From a patient care perspective, we also have infrastructure in place to screen our patients for recent travel. So I think when facing any infectious disease threat like the Zika virus, it's important to remain calm and to arm ourselves with the facts. And the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention is an excellent resource to get information and to stay abreast of the current advisories and recommendations to protect ourselves.